you open your heart to the Lord and God will speak to you. God will reveal to you. Ask Him not to save you from your problems, but ask Him, Daddy, why did you create me? What is happening to me? What am I supposed to do? What is happening to reveal your plan for me? Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11 onwards, he says, surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. The plans I have for you is for your welfare and not for your harm. I want to give you a future with hope. When you know my plan and you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. I will reveal my plans to you. Many of the times we don't go to God. We remain somewhere else. We remain with our problems. It's like a fellow who went inside the house, it seems, and locked all the windows, and he was crying, Lord, I'm getting sweaty. Very hot. I'm sweating. Then the Lord said, open the windows. And when he opened the windows, gentle breeze came. Many of the times we close ourselves and we die in our own little thinking, I have got this problem, I have got that problem, I can't come out of this. No, you have to open the door, windows which he has given to you. Let the gentle breeze come in. St. John's Gospel chapter 4, one day in the afternoon time, Jesus went to a place, a Samaritan village. And in that Samaritan village, a particular lady lived a sinful life. To the world, she is a sinful lady. But God, she is also his daughter. To the world, maybe she lived with 5 men. But for God, she is his daughter. He wants to save his daughter. Village people, they said, they were all accusing her, blaming her. Maybe some might have said, can't you get a rope to hang yourself? You are destroying our village. You have spoiled our family. You brought problem to our family. Many things they might have told. So she, if somebody goes on blames you, what? You don't feel like seeing their face. So she didn't want to come in the morning along with the other women to collect the water. So in the afternoon, nobody will be coming. It is very hot. I will go collect the water and come back. She didn't want to hear all the accusations, all the hurting things. She's already wounded and bleeding. And Jesus, so hot it is. No tree. But Jesus is waiting for this woman. He who died on the cross for you, he will do anything for you because you are precious. He can't afford to see you being wounded and bleeding. That's why in the Psalm 34 verse 18 it is written, God is close to the brokenhearted. That's why in the book of Ezekiel chapter 18 verse 23 he said, I don't want even a single child of mine to perish. Everyone, I want them to come back to me. They are my children. Maybe to the eyes of the world, she is a sinner. Maybe to the eyes of the world, she made blunders. But for me, she is my daughter. That's why in the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 28, he said, all those who are tired in life, all those who are heavily laden, broken in life, come to me. apart. I will give you rest. Take my yoke, what I give you, because He Himself will carry your yoke. Are you broken? Are you wounded? Are you disturbed? He is calling you. And this lady, she did not understand Jesus, because the Jews don't move with Samaritans, and still worse, they think women are less mind. Jesus wanted to break that. So He came and He was talking to that woman. Jesus humbled Himself and went to her and said, "Give me water." He will do anything for you to capture you, to help you to understand there is someone who loves you as you are. Maybe the world tells you, if you change, we will love you. If you do this, we will love you. But here is your God tells you, what you are doesn't matter to me. What matters is you are mine. I want to belong to you. I want you to be my son, my daughter. I love you. You need this love in your life to heal off your wounds. Only then you can think of yourself clearly. And the Lord said a beautiful word, you know. He said, if only you knew the gift of God for you. What? God has gift for me. I am a wounded lady. Everybody blames me. Everybody calls me prostitute. Everybody says you lived with the 5 fellows. Everybody says you destroyed our family. Everybody says you are a burden for our family. And Jesus says, if only you knew God's gift for you. God has created you and He will bear you. He will be with you until He makes you as His own. Until you understand His dream, His plan for you. He will be with you. He will be walking with you. That's what we read in the book of Ephesians, chapter 3, verse 20. God is at work in us. God is at work in us. That the plan of God may be revealed through us. God is at work in you. Yes. That's what we read in the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 13 also. God wants to reveal His purpose through me. So God is at work in me. Praise the Lord. We all of us have problem of finance, problem of family, our own physical problem, maybe sickness, maybe problem of various kinds. But our daddy's love for us will overrule everything. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.